Shanji, can you explain non-doing, what you teach for many, many years?
Non-doing is the realization that one is never a doer. Whatever one does, one is simply led to do that. Whether one meditates or one drinks whiskey, it is all in the cosmic divine scheme that somehow that person is led to do that. But one should not believe in non-doing. That is one thing I want to emphasize as strongly as I can. One should try to realize non-doing. And what that means, how can one try and how can one realize? First, one should work on oneself by trying to determine whether he or she creates any thought, any desire, or these thoughts and desire bubble up on their own. That is the number one thing. Whether one does anything as a doer to create these thoughts and desires, or these thoughts and desires, good or bad, bubble up, surface on their own. Second point is, when they surface on their own, one does nothing to like or dislike them. Automatically, each one of us, Jesus as well as Judas, when these thoughts and desires bubble up, they either end up liking or disliking, approving or disapproving of that thought, of that desire. That is number two. Number three, the decision that I will pursue this desire, or I will pursue this thought, or I will avoid this thought, or I will avoid this desire. This decision that for which all of us, the great intellectuals, even Nobel Prize winners, all of us generally believe that we do something to make a particular decision, good or bad. Non-doing teaches that this decision is made for each one of us based on one's own inner chemistry, our own inner memory bank. In that memory bank, all the impressions are stored, not only from this lifetime, from many, many lifetimes. Based on all those impressions, each one of us ends up either accepting or rejecting a particular thought or desire. So the decision is made. Automatically, by life itself, by the flow of events themselves, one is doing absolutely nothing to make a decision. Then the fourth part is, that is rather simpler than the third part. Once a decision is made, one does nothing to execute that decision. Automatically, body executes, fulfills that thought or desire. Like if I have decided I have to drink water, then I do nothing to make my body get up for the glass of water. It is very subtle, but when one examines for several days, or weeks, or months, or years, or even lifetimes, this thing becomes clear. It requires lot of purification to understand this simple thing, that neither one creates a thought or desire, neither one approves or disapproves of any thought or desire, and not one make any decision about it. Decision is made by his or her own memory bank. And fourth, once the decision is made, body automatically fulfills it. Like my shadow automatically follows my body, this body automatically follows that decision. So these are four pillars of non-doing to realize. Other thing I would share that is apart from this kind of approach, but that is more subtle. And the subtle part is this. I as an individual, that is called Shantanand. I know myself as Shantanand with this form. In whatever it is, rich, poor, ugly, old, young, it doesn't matter. The way I know myself as an individual in waking state, that is one experience. Then the same me knows myself in the dream state. And that conviction in the dream that I am this dreaming self is as solid as this conviction, I am this Swami Shantanand. It is very subtle, very powerful. And the still more subtle part is that when one falls asleep, one does not have any connection, any memory, any shadow of this waking state or dreaming state. So that is called one can transcend both on a daily basis, waking state as well as dreaming state. So now the wisdom part is this. My God, I am in all the three states, then who am I? I cannot say I don't exist. I have been in all the three states. Nor I can say I am this gross body of waking state because it did not participate in this form and in this situation in the dreaming state. Nor I can say I am that self of dreaming state because when I wake up, I don't find it anymore existing. Nor I can say dreaming self or waking self, anyone is real because both are totally wiped out in sound sleep. So this understanding does not make a permanent grip in our heart only because our heart is not pure. Otherwise, there is no higher wisdom than this, that I am transcendental. Because what is transcendental? The you that knows waking state, that knows dreaming state, that knows sleeping state, remains constant in all the three states, and yet it cannot be in any way known or determined on the basis of three states. So when one catches, recognizes with as much intensity as one humanly experiences, then one becomes liberated. Oh.
What is the source of our actions? Is it our memory bank or the divine source?
In ultimate analysis, it is always the divine source for anything and everything. But we cannot cop out in the name of the source. Individually, we have to take full responsibility for our actions. And when we become liberated by recognizing, realizing this truth, that we have this unshakable knowing, then it is all the same, drama of the one, in your form, in my form, in his form, in her form, in the form of a murderer, in the form of the rapist, in the form of the Buddha, Jesus, Krishna, all. Oh.
When you say we need to learn to speak the truth, what is truth?
Very good, very good. We do not have to learn to speak the truth. by nature, by instinct, we all are given, inspired to speak the truth. If I ask a baby, have you eaten? Have you done your homework? Or have you today attended to your school? Naturally, a child or each one of us tell the truth. There is nothing to hide about it. But when there is some fear that if I tell the truth, then the consequences are bad. I did not do the homework, and if I tell I did not do the homework, then the teacher will punish, parents will punish. So in the process of our growth, we learn to lie. But those of us who somehow become convinced, that although they could also lie, but lying does not serve the purpose. It divides one. That is why we have all these mental problems. In my understanding and my belief, all these psychologists, psychiatrists, and all those, they have not gone to the root cause of the problem. The root cause of the problem is very simple and very solid. If children are made to be truthful, are inspired to be truthful, are taught to be truthful, and how can they be taught to be truthful? When parents are truthful, otherwise how can they learn? They cannot learn by our lip teaching. They know that somebody calls on telephone, tell that person, I am out of home or I am in bathroom. Children see it every day. So that is why it is very, very shallow to tell about children that be truthful, because we are ourselves untruthful. But those great beings in all religions, in my belief, they must have all have practiced this truthfulness, and through the glory of truthfulness, when their heart becomes pure, they gain the divine grace. And in that divine grace, somehow, what is the proof of divine grace? There is no fear. Who can hurt and how? For them, these thoughts and these kind of patterns don't unfold in their system, because heart is pure. All these fears, somebody may come and steal, somebody may come and rob, somebody may come and rape, somebody may come and murder. This is only projection of our impure heart. When heart is pure, there is only one existence, there is only one power, and there is only one will. One existence, one power, one will. So it is all glory and play of oneness. Just oneness. Just oneness.
Can you explain what Sanatana Dharma is?
Sanatana Dharma. Thank you, Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana means eternal. Eternal means permanent, lasting, that cannot be broken, that remains steady. That is the literal meaning of Sanatana. And Dharma means, there is no English equivalent word for Dharma, but I will try. Dharma means action that leads to ultimate realization. So, Sanatana Dharma is that kind of practice, that kind of belief, that kind of lifestyle that leads one to one's own innermost self, that is universal, eternal, and ever blissful.
What is a good way or better ways to get in touch with our inner higher self?
Beautiful question. The better and the best way is seek out the company of those whom you sense and feel through your own personal experience that this person is more happy, more content, more fearless, more playful, more truthful, and more kind, more clear, and more. I mean, whatever you are aspiring in your own life, the person somehow demonstrates to you that he has got that, that you want to have in your life. So if we seek the company of those persons who give us the impression that they have got a little, if not all the way, extra glimpse or extra grip over that quality, over that wisdom, over that freedom, then seeking company of those person is the best way. And then reading scriptures, books by these enlightened people, they inspire us and they somehow help us to see where we are going wrong. Then other simple things, maintaining a diary on a daily basis, how I behave today, how I goofed up, and how I was able to maintain my integrity. All these simple things help. And patience is very important. Like a river is flowing, even if we dam the flow of water, but water does not stop its intensity to move forward towards the ocean. So likewise, all of us, all human beings have that inner instinctive urge, our instinctive fire to reach that ultimate source. Because only in that ultimate source lies the ultimate freedom, ultimate bliss, and ultimate satisfaction. So seeking the company of those such persons, reading such scriptures, watching such videotapes, maintaining a regulated life, not for the sake of punishing, or for the sake of making money, or for the sake of boyfriend or girlfriend, it is just for the sake of your own purification and your own realization. Oh.
Recently, a guru in India was accused of having sex with his students.
Wow.
And he was taken to a court and found guilty and has now received a jail sentence. Do you think it's okay to have sex with one's students, especially if you are a guru?
As long as one is inclined to have sex, as long as one is susceptible to have sex, sex is like an animal, impulsive urge. And all our restrictions that we create in society are just made for the sake of society to run smoothly. There is no such thing that guru cannot have sex with the disciple. It is a very wrong idea. But somehow it is accepted in the society, so nothing is bad with that. Many gurus don't have sex with their students, many do have from the time immemorial. It is nothing that one should have or not have. It is just one's own discretion or one's own inclination. So that is how I will respond. And about that man, he was not having sex, he was raping his students, so-called students. So rape is always the most vulgar thing to happen in human life. I think if there is a shooting punishment, rapist should be shot dead. There is no hanky-panky about this. They should be given such harsh punishment in front of everybody in a public place. So those of us, when we see that, we know that it can happen to me also if I rape someone. And somehow, somebody is sentenced to death and some privately, so it does not register in our consciousness how painful it can be. Somehow society in general has to be exposed what kind of agony and pain one goes through when one commits that kind of crime. And what else? Keep on asking very clearly in one line. Oh.
What is ultimate truth about ourselves? Who are we?
Beautiful, beautiful. Who are we? We are the substratum of all existence. We are pure consciousness that pervades our mind, our body, our surroundings, everything, like in the dream. If a dreaming self asks, or dreaming person asks, who am I? And suppose there is an enlightened person in the dream, so what he or she can tell? He or she can only tell, you are everything, or you as an individual of the dream, not everything, but your mind. Not the mind of the dreaming self, but that mind which created the whole dream world. Everything comes out of the dreaming mind that projects all that dream. So it is just like that, this consciousness, cosmic consciousness, has somehow manifested. Or it seems to us who are in this dreaming form, waking state is like also a dreaming form. So I say, oh, Bira is there, this building is there, this is America, and this is India. And where does anything or any person or any country come from? It's like same source, like dream, whole dream world, where does it come from? Suppose I was in a dream, where does this whole dream world comes from? So it is just like that. But by intellectual understanding, it does not make any difference. I have been in this country for last 30, 40 years. And same thing in India, I would say, it is not better. Let me share one thing, story. Thank you. I'm very happy that I will tell this story. You will be surprised to hear. Many doctors, Indian doctors, were going to beat me for this statement. I was speaking in a doctor's home who was a multimillionaire. He invited 25, 30 Indian doctors, and I ended up saying like this. When for the first time I went to India from America, I told my friends or devotees that if I am born again, I would rather be born as a prostitute in America than a holy man in India. Why did I say that? The reason is very subtle and very, very powerful. The reason is, I saw when I was in America, people were much more truthful, much more transparent than in India. And since I practiced for many, many years truthfulness, I thought, my God, in India takes so much glory about religion and spirituality and God, but it is all hocus pocus in comparison to the truthfulness of Americans. So that is one thing. Other thing, America is also very dumb in certain sense. Dumb is this, they think because they have this scientific gadget, they have been rulers all over the country, they have more what you call weapons, and they have universities, Harvard and whatever. Let me tell you, so I told one time, that is also interesting. Andher Nagari Chaupat Raja, Take Ser Bhaji, Take Ser Khaja. I will not be able to translate so good, but the basic meaning is, it is such a dumb country, ki anything can be sold in any price. People have no any sense of recognition. Anything that goes, it goes. Totally, totally dumb. So that was also my experience. Because time is limited, so I don't want to get into that experience. Otherwise, something like that, once I was going to be put into jail. And I was given the choice. If I would admit I am guilty, there would be no jail. I said, oh my God, I would rather go to jail than say I am admit. I am guilty. Even my attorney suggested, you admit guilt. I said, no, that is not my belief. I am willing to be hanged. That is why I hated Rajneesh Osho also. When he was given the choice, either you admit this or that, we will let you go back to India, or you will be in the prison house. For his common sense or his whatever, he preferred to go to India. He died after a year or two. He kept on cursing Ronald Reagan and all that. But I would say he himself was not established in truth. When I met with him and asked him a certain question, he abused me in such a way. I again went to see him in the night time. I was not supposed to speak, but still I spoke. And he was saying, no, you are not supposed to speak here. I wanted to slap in his face. But I have common sense. There were so much bodyguards. I didn't want to be beaten up there. But I knew it is hocus pocus. But still, with all his hocus pocus, I read his books. I enjoy his lectures. He is the best spokesperson in modern times. So spirituality is very, very deep. It is not, how many followers, how much money. best teachers in India, they have got my full respect. First was Ramakrishna Paramahans, second was Raman Maharshi. These two are the ultimate in modern times. Even Krishnamurti, I went to hear him several times. I have met lot of gurus. That was my hobby since a boy. Rajneesh Neem Karoli Baba. I don't want to get into story. People, oh, Neem Karoli Baba. I said, Neem Karoli Baba. So many stories in my life that I am not that kind of sissy. Once you have the fire of truth, nothing can ever frighten you. As long as anything can frighten you, you are not established in truth. Oh.
What kind of government, what kind of political system would you imagine, envision?
Oh, beautiful. Wow. May God bless you for that question. I would imagine then whole world should have only one government now, because our internet has removed our boundaries. And for that, I want all the countries to decide among themselves who is the most wise person, man or woman. I believe such 7 persons, just 7, not 8, not 9, or 6, should be recognized. And how can they be recognized? There should be spiritual conferences in which all these so-called whom we hear and believe or guess he or she could be enlightened, we bring them together and they debate there. Many of them will try to outsmart each other. But the glory of truth is such that ultimately the one who is really, really grounded in truth, people can know it. There is something about the energy, the conviction, the fragrance, the freedom, the laughter of that person who is grounded in truth. So if that is done, then those 7 persons will decide who is worthy of those kind of executive powers that we give to so-called president or prime minister. And then he or she can make his own team. So that is how I would say, this worst thing that is prevalent in my understanding in all countries, secret voting, secret ballot box. This is the most bogus thing. It has made all of us very, very sissy, very, very fearful. Nobody wants to be known whom he or she voted for. And then if they cannot be fearless in simple voting, how can they be fearless when they become senators and congressmen and women? It is just same people who are clever and untruthful and cheaters here, they turn out to be congressmen and women and senators and all that. So politics should start with utter truthfulness, utter fearlessness. Oh.
What would you consider to be the laws of this one world? If there are laws, what would be the rights and the laws of this one world government or nation?
I would say this is the most simple thing. Even you, even him, or anyone should agree. And these are first my safety. I should feel safe that nobody is going to hurt me, beat me and kill me. Safety, physical safety, number one. Number two, equality. Equality, somebody is earning millions and billions and trillions of dollars, somebody is struggling to make $20. To me, it is very, very, it divides humanity. Then automatically those who are very poor, they are thinking how to rob and how to murder. Why should they not think if somebody is depriving them of their own joy? Because those who have money, they can hire for them as a cook, as a massage, who give them massage, or who drives their car, or who does lawn mowing for them. They should have, I believe, only 10 times maximum difference. If I make $10, the highest person, the person who makes highest, he should make $100. If anybody makes more than that, that money should become part of the society, part of the humanity, and they should be recognized in many other forms by social events. There should be many, many more social events. Children should be always kept busy with singing, dancing, playing, and singing God's glory. I mean, the world can become a heaven, such a beautiful heaven, that any imagination of we have of that heaven could be around us.
What would be your closing statement to us all at this time?
My closing statement: be yourself. In being yourself lies ultimate freedom, ultimate joy, ultimate glory of existence. Mm-hmm. Only when you be yourself, you can serve others. Otherwise, you are just playing a game, fooling yourself and fooling others. Om, om, om. Okay, who are you, my dear Holy One? Hello? Find who? She or he disappeared. I don't know, because I have to think how to go and who called and
Frank
all
that. And Shani.
Huh? Who?
Frank and Shani.
Call them, what they want. Mm. Give me. There's number there somewhere. You know all these things. So, I don't have $100, you got $100 for this service, and this is, video is done, and this is the best. You don't have to edit anything, it is done. You understand?